Our Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the sacrifice. We thank you for a safe journey here as the roads and streets are pretty slick. We pray that we all are traveling and then try to save. We ask that we open your word and stay as listening to your spirit here with us. God, bless upon our minds and our hearts the truth you have for us in this lesson. Help us, Lord, to have discernment of what that means to our lives and we're going to let you lead out. These things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Eyes of the world, Lord, this world world you. Our text this morning is the eyes of the Lord are in every place, keeping watch upon the evil and the good. When we talk about the world view, you know, if we go back in history as far as what people thought they knew about the world was pretty false. Go back in history, there's still some people believe that the world is flat, a flat Earth society. At one time, the world thought that the Earth was the center of the universe, that the sun and the stars all revolved around the Earth. Hey, Robert, did some echo going on? Do you hear echo?
No.
There's echo? No?
You hear echo?
Anyway, so over time, people's idea of what the world is and all about can change because we've proven wrong before. I mean, it talks about the worldview. What is our worldview? How would you describe it? What is our worldview? When we think of our worldview, think about it. How does the world work? Why do things happen? How do we go on? And some people have a worldview that there's a secret world organization that is manipulating things behind the scenes to cause certain things to happen that we're really in control of. And so how we look at the world, think of the world, has an impact on us. How many of you have seen or heard about the movie The Matrix 20 years ago? And that was a story about how humans are living in a computer simulation. And what they thought the world was all totally wrong. And there are some philosophers who have that think that, yeah, there's a chance that we're all pretty living right now in a computer simulation. So what is real? How do you determine what's real? What can you trust? Can you trust the government to tell you what's real? Can you trust the news to tell you what's real? All these things come down to people view the worldview as it's all natural, or that the Big Bang happened and started the universe changing, evolving over time over billions of years. 13, 14 billions of years that claim it took to get to our own now. It's just a matter of atoms and the forces of nature. The Christian worldview is different. Why? Why is our worldview different? We believe there is a God that created the earth. And there are different religions in the world. So there's people that believe our God did it. Other religions have a multitude of gods that somehow they create the world in different scenarios. But by having that belief that God created the world, it makes us think how and why things happen is different from those who are, say, atheists. Let's go to Psalms 53. Psalms chapter 53. Verse 1. The fool says in his heart, there is no God. Bible will often thinks it's God. It says the fool is one that's what there's not. Let's go to Proverbs 15. Proverbs 15, verse 3. Eyes of the Lord are everywhere. Keep watch on the wicked and the good. How does that influence our worldview? The Bible says God's eyes are everywhere. Watch. Nothing we can get away from. Is there anything we can do that God doesn't? John 3:16 tells us what? To a virgin, let it be center, and not be afraid of it. We have found favor with God. We will proceed and give birth to a son, who will call the call of Jesus. We will be grateful for being called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give to him from him as Father David. The reign of Jesus descends forever. His kingdom will never end. How will this be? Mary asked, the son of Virgin. The angel answered, the Holy Spirit will come on you. Power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One will be born and will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, will call her a child in her old age. And she who is said to be unable to conceive is in the sixth month. So look at that story of the angel and Mary. How's that shape her thoughts? Starts out with a question. Why is there something instead of nothing? Why is there something instead of nothing? Because that's the same question. Why are we here? Is there a purpose of all existence? God has a plan for us. He wants us to do something. He wants us to reach other people, to tell them about him. So why? Atheists believe, say, just a big bang happened. That over billions of years, organisms changed and grew out of that part of us came humans. God says something different. Go back to Genesis, chapter 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Go to John 1. is with God and the kingdom. Through him, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made as it was made. In him was life. That life is the light of all mankind. Let's turn to Exodus chapter 20. Does the Bible explain or justify why this would happen? Does the book should say this is the whole Bible starts out in the beginning, God created. Does it lay out the foundation for the doctrine that says there is? How many mothers of God? How many mothers of God? Why doesn't that work? Forestburg, there, and that, and that as well. Remember. The other commandments don't have that. Thank God you knew that. People are attention to forget, or latch on to some other theory, operation. So remember. It's just that you have to remember. The Sabbath day is the focus on God's power to create. That if we take away that from the religion of God.
But how many people do you think remember that it's the Sabbath day? That they go and do their own thing. So don't you think that word remember there means something a lot more than to just recognize it's the Sabbath day?
True. I think it's true that people may know in their mind that the Sabbath day is the Sabbath, but they do the wrong thing. I don't want to hope so much as the world doesn't think it's important. Some Christian religions believe wrongly in what they call the Sabbath, but the Sunday. When you go back in history, the Protestant and Catholic churches have very strong views on how you keep Sunday, because that is the Sabbath. They believe a lot, so God says, remember. Remember the seventh day. When you go with evolution, try to meld evolution with God. It says, well, God used evolution to create humans. And at what point does sin come in? We evolved from other species to that Homo sapiens. Where's sin? Unless we're created perfect, you can't look at the sinless, the lawless one. Mayor Tuesday's lesson talks about the scripture creates a template which helps better understand the reality. Scripture helps us understand the reality of what we do. How do we say it? How do we do that? What's our reality? Our reality is we believe in God. Our reality is that this world is not a nice place sometimes. Why do we believe the world is not a nice place sometimes? Without the knowledge of sin, Satan, how could we explain the evil? If you're an atheist and you look around and saw the evil of the world, how do you explain it? You know, some people are good, some people are bad.
It's hard to explain the evil. You now. Whatever that means.
Jesus told me to grab a little Bible. Well, they got to go back and I say, first sentence started. They just say, oh, humans are separate. Can you humans do that? When the atheists look at the rainbow, what do they see? The atheists look at the rainbow. What do they see? They say, yep, because of what sunshine and refraction of raindrops and face these colors. They're explaining scientifically. When we see a rainbow, what do you think? We also see the colors. What else?
What's going on?
our park, that we drew what side we want off of. And the atheists, they just, sometimes people are good, sometimes they're evil. That's it. No explanation. Oh, yes, are we motivated more by wisdom of men and women than wisdom of God? Oh, God. Because wisdom of man, how's that compared to God? Mankind can do a lot of things. They can change things, but they can't make something out of that. Only God can do that. Only God has that power, which is why it's God. It lays out that there's more to this world than what we see. There's a spiritual realm. That when you battle against God of Christ, you lose the battle. Let's turn to Romans, Mark 13.
Everyone. And we're supposed to respond to that love.
Find out what that was for reasons. One of my very good verses, Ecclesiastes, verse 5, my chapter 9. Let's talk about the Redeemer, how important it is to have a realization of our Redeemer. Why is that one part of our responsibility that we have in the But we have a Redeemer. Some people don't. And we will. But who's that? But having a Redeemer is important. Go with John, we'll look back to chapter 1 of John, talks about the Word. What's this God, what is this God, through the Word that was created. It says the Word became flesh. It says God became flesh. He died for us, to be us. And that's, think about that. Think about who God is and came to be a human. Is that a big jump? Is that a big change? There's a way that appears to be right. At the end of Lee's death, in verse, chapter 16, he repeats it. 16:25. There's a way that appears to be right, but the end of Lee's death. Some translation says, there's a way that appears right to a man, but it leads to death. Deuteronomy chapter 6. Deuteronomy chapter 6. Verse 5. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. Love your God with all your heart, soul, and strength. Have all kinds of worldly education. though it has been knowledge, it must be have knowledge of God, bias, and so it doesn't do a whole lot of good. Number three is you have after the name doesn't measure your love for God. It's different. It's time to close. One second. One prayer. Our Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you again for the Sabbath. We pray for it. Let your word be in our heart. Let our hearts be circumcised that there be a true relationship between you and us. Help us, Lord, not to wander from the word. Let's get rid of the world. We'll be in the world and not our world. For these things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.